Today we will discuss second application of dimensional analysis, that is deducing relation among various physical quantities. For this application, what we have to keep in our mind is principle of homogeneity and the factors on which a physical quantity depends. Principle of homogeneity states that like quantities can be added, like quantities can be subtracted, or if a given equation is dimensionally correct, then each term either on left hand side or on right hand side should have same dimensions. So for finding relation between various physical quantity, a physical quantity will be given to you and it will be told that it depends on how many physical quantities. And we have to find the relation between them. For example, this is given that a simple pendulum is there and its bob is attached to a string that oscillates under the action of gravity. Let us consider this is the string and this is the bob. This bob is displaced to this extreme position and then left. What will happen? Because of effect of gravity, it will come this side. It will overshoot its mean position, it will go to other side, and then it will come to mean position, and then it will go to this position again. Now when the bob is going, let us consider it is going to start its movement from here. So time taken by bob to go from A to B and then back to A is known as time period. Time that is taken by bob to go from A to B then back B to A is said to be time period. It means time taken to complete one oscillation, that will be known as time period. Now this is given, this time period of the bob depends upon the length, it depends on the mass of the bob and acceleration due to gravity. Now we have to find how time period is dependent on all these quantities, whether it is dependent or not, whether it has direct relation, if it has direct relation with which power, or if it is indirect relation, then what is the power. To solve questions like this, the first step is you will consider that a given physical quantity has direct relation with other physical quantities. So time period is directly dependent on length, mass and acceleration due to gravity. Now we don't know what is the power of length, mass and acceleration due to gravity. Also we don't know whether these powers are positive or negative. So we have considered time period is directly dependent upon length raised to power A, mass raised to power B and acceleration gravity raised to power C. When we will remove this proportionality sign, then equality sign will be there and this is constant of proportionality. Whenever we will do questions like this, always we will consider that this constant of proportionality is dimensionless, because this is the limitation of dimensional analysis, that we cannot find the value, we cannot have any idea about this constant of proportionality. So in every solution we will consider K is going to be dimensionless constant. So after using this constant of proportionality equation, we will get in this form where K is dimensionless constant. Next step is we will write dimensions of various physical quantities which are present in equation 1. This is time period. Its dimension will be T1. Length L1. We will not write K here because K is dimensionless. Mass M1. G acceleration due to gravity L1T minus 2. A, B, C as it is. Next step, these two will be multiplied. So we'll get LA, MB, LC, T minus 2C. Now we will rearrange the terms and we will have MB. This is LA multiplied by LC. All these are in multiplication. So MB, LA, LC, bases are same. So during multiplication, powers will be added. So we will get MB, LA plus C, T minus 2C. Now comparing the dimensions of similar quantities, it means comparing the dimension of mass with mass, length with length, time with time. So here we have m raised to power 0, here m raised to power b. So b will be equal to 0 a plus c will be equal to 0, minus 2c is equal to 1. When you will solve, c will be minus half. Put value of c here, you will get a is equal to half. A, b, c, these values are with us. So these values we will put in equation first. What we will get? T is equal to k, l raised to power half, m raised to power 0, g raised to power minus half. This will give you 1, so we will not write it further. So we will get finally t is equal to k under the root lg. This is relation between time period, length, acceleration due to gravity, and time period is independent of mass of ball. So like this we have to solve the question. Let us consider one more example. Example is, the velocity v of water wave depends on wavelength, density of water, and acceleration due to gravity. We have to find the relation. So first step is, we will consider velocity is directly dependent upon wavelength raised to power a, density raised to power b, and acceleration gravity raised to power c. Remove proportionality sign, equality sign, and constant of proportionality. This constant of proportionality is a dimensionless constant. Write dimensions of all the physical quantities either on left hand side or on right hand side. So this is velocity m0 l1 t minus 1, k dimensionless constant, wavelength will have dimension of length raised to power a, density mass per unit volume. So dimensional formula will be m1 l minus 3 raised to power b, g acceleration due to gravity, so it will have l1 t minus 2 raised to power c. When you will solve it, you will be able to get equation like this, and after rearranging the terms you will get m0 l1 t minus 1, l raised to power a minus 3b plus c, m raised to power b, t raised to power minus 2c. Again rearranging the terms and comparing the powers of similar quantities. So mass raised to power 0. So here b will be equal to 0. A minus 3b plus c will be equal to 1. Minus 2c will be equal to minus 1. So from here c will be half. B will be 0. Put both the values in this equation, you will get a half. Put value of a, b, c in equation first. So you will be able to get v is equal to k under the root lambda g. Now few limitations are of this application of dimensional analysis. Limitations are, we don't have any idea about dimensionless constant k. Also, if one physical quantity is dependent on more than three physical quantity, then this method will not work. Also, this is working whenever we are finding the result in multiplication or in division. If your result is in terms of addition or subtraction, then also this method fails. And this method fails to derive relation which involve trigonometric function, logarithmic function, or exponential function.